Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to wrap a triangle-shaped cabochon. If you'd like to see my start-to-finish process, stay tuned! I have 4 pieces of 20 gauge square dead soft copper wire, and they're around 11 inches long. And I'm going to start weaving with 26 gauge round wire, and I'll start with just one base wire here, and I'm going to coil this weaving wire around 3 or 4 times. Now I'll add my next wire, and I'm going to coil it to the first wire twice. Okay, then I'll add my third base wire, and I'm also going to coil this to the second wire 2 times as well. And now I'll add my last base wire, and again I'm just coiling it to the one before it 2 times. Then I'll follow the same pattern down the other side to form a little triangle shape. Okay, I'm going to repeat this weave 4 more times, so I have 5 little triangles total, and I'm going to speed this part up a bit. Okay, now we can bend these right in the center to get it ready to shape it around our stone. All right, I'm going to bend these two wires to hold the stone from the back. I want to kind of hold these wires in place from the front as I carefully bend them around the corners up top here. I want to keep them nice and flush with each other. And I want to leave a little bit of space up here at the top and just adjust these until they're even. I'm going to straighten these back wires just a bit. And after I snip those down, I'll get everything nice and flush. And then I'm gonna bring these back wires down and around the other base wires to tie them together. And I'm going nice and slow as I do this, and I'm being really gentle with the tension that I'm using with my pliers. Okay, now I can finish securing the stone from the front. I'm using my thumb to hold the top of this wire still as I gently bend at the bottom here to capture the stone from the front and tighten up the cage. And now I'll finish the top wires with some decorative work. I'm going to be trying to keep these nice and flush against each other as I shape them around. I'm just gently flattening these out with my pliers, careful not to leave any marks in the wire. And now I'm going to create the loop that the pendant will hang from. And I'll finish these wires off by wrapping them around each other. And I'm making sure to tuck these wires in nice and tight so they don't come loose or snag on clothing when they're being worn. And you can do these differently if you prefer. Like you can add some loops before bending them around and snipping them off. Just make sure you leave a space right in the center for where you're going to hang your jump ring. Thank you. Now we can make our jump ring. I call this a figure eight jump ring, although there might be a more official industry name for it. This is a piece of 20 gauge square wire and it's 6 inches long. And I'm just bending it right in the center and I'm gonna gently squeeze it closed as much as possible. And now I'll shave it with my baling pliers. Alright, and now I can oxidize. And I almost forgot, we also want to gently adjust our wires on the back to secure the corners and make sure that the stone won't fall out from the top. All right, and there's our finished pendant. And here's a couple others that I've made with this design. You can use 19 gauge wire, and that's what I used with this one. And you can also use 18 gauge wire as well. Although I wouldn't go smaller than 20 gauge because I would be concerned that the top entwined part would bend too easily. But yeah, if your stone is a little bit more thick, you may wanna go with a 19 or an 18 gauge wire. This one is 18 gauge. All right, guys, thanks so much for joining me today. I really hope you enjoyed this project. Let me know what you think in the comments. If you'd like to help me make more of these tutorials, please hit the like button and consider sharing on your social media because that's really what helps my channel grow. And don't forget to subscribe and tap the bell so you get notified every time I upload a new video. Also, if you follow me on Instagram, feel free to share pictures of your creations with me. I love to see what my tutorials inspire. I'm also on TikTok now, so you can follow me there as well. And I just want to end by saying have a fantastic day and remember to love your neighbor as yourself and in all things treat others as you want to be treated, for this is the law and the prophets. God bless you guys, and I hope to see you in the next video.